Come on, dung beetle. Feed. No, I almost fed it. Are you mad at me? What are you doing? I'm irritated with this dung beetle. Stupid dung beetle. I'm gonna go get another one. Hey there, everybody. Mazion reporting for duty, and today we're going to go and find ourselves a dung beetle in a cave. But first, I just got back from PAX. I'm super, super tired. I just want to sleep like all day long, but we can't do that. Got work to do. So I came on today, and it's been about, I don't know, an hour and a half. I got some more ceilings. So we're up to 617 ceilings, and we're going to continue to do that every day. Every day get on, make some ceilings, and then continue on. And I'm not going to actually do a build here until I've got 1,200 ceilings, and I'm going to need some more walls. So I'm gonna work on it, like, all the free time I got. I'm going to make some ceilings, make some walls, because, like, the first layer down there is going to be 400 ceilings. That layer is going to be 400 ceilings, and that layer is only for aquatic animals, and then the layer above that is going to be the main floor. So we need the main floor to have, you know, our vaults and, you know, fabricator, smithy, that kind of stuff up there. So there's no real point in, like, making that base or starting that base area until I can make the main floor. So we need 1,200 ceilings. So we're about halfway there. And we should be able to get there pretty quickly. But today, one thing that I do want to do is I want to go out and find one of these dung beetles. And I was told, I actually tamed up this saber tooth sack in order to go into one of the caves. But I was told that it would be way easier. Melee damage. If I just took an Argentavis into the cave that's north of Slipgator, which is northeast of where I'm located, and you can fly the RG and grab a dung beetle, and then I can just tame it out. So that's what we're going to attempt to do today. I'm going to go over to that cave, see if we can grab a dung beetle or two, probably two of those, and we're going to bring them back to the base and get them tamed up. Look, a green drop. I wonder if there's anything cool inside. We're going to have a look. So PAX was really fun. I had a good time. It was my first experience where people, like, wanted to take pictures of me and whatnot. And it was kind of, it was a really humbling experience. But it was really, really fun. Had a good time over there hanging out with Drax. Met Drax and Zul'jin. Those guys are fun guys. And of course, I already know my brother. So that was fun as well. It was nice to see him. Just junk that I don't care about. I took the paintbrush blueprint because then we can unlearn that Engram someday. Won't need it anymore. Alright, so I'm going to go over to the cave, we're going to fly in there, and grab ourselves up a dung beetle or two. Alright, so we're outside of the cave entrance, is roughly this area on the map, you can see it. I'm not going to try to predict, never know. But apparently you can get Argentavis in here. Now, that's what I'm told, so we need to find a way. How do I get the Argentavis in? Is it one of the follow-y type bits, or is it the, I don't know if this is a thing that I can do. Maybe I heard about the wrong cave, but we'll try it all the same. Come on, Argentavis guy. Let's go in here. Can you come in? Can you come? I don't know. This doesn't seem like it's the right cave. Not in the everything is narrow. So this can't be the right cave. I gotta find out what cave. I mean, we can go fly into other caves. You probably could go into the Chitin cave in the mouth. So that cave, not an Argentavis cave. We gotta find ourselves a place where we can go in on an Argentavis. Alright, so we're outside of the cave that we can fly into. And I was told that was the cave directly north of Slipgator's base, which is the one that's directly north is to the south. But this is another one that's north of Slipgator's base. And I've been here before. We can definitely fly an Argentavis in. So we're gonna go in and see if we can find ourselves a dung beetle. And see how close to the entrance we can locate one. Kind of dark in here. I think maybe Gamma 2.4 and Gamma 3. Yeah, Gamma 3 is all right. Let's try that. Here, dung beetle, dung beetle, dung beetle, dung poop beetle. Bats! Do not press E and cave. Man, these bats are strong. Or my Argentavis is weak, which is probably the more likely of the two. You killed one of the bats? One bat! Kill the other bats. Come on! Man, what a pain in the butt. Used to be way easier. Alright, so hopefully there'll be a dung beetle close. I don't see any dung beetles. It's hard to see what's going on in here. More bats! Come here to me, bats. I shall smite thee with my talon. Talon! Two! You have been smote by talons. Should have named my Argentavis Smoter. Alright, so I'm not seeing a dung beetle anywhere here. But there are more bats to fight. And my Argentavis is actually a little hurt. You have to be careful while fighting Onyx in this cave. Why did I not hit that? Oh. Alright, so that's all taken care of. There's a snake down here. I see spiders. Snakes. Oh, is that a dung beetle? That is a dung beetle! Did I pick it up? Of course I didn't. One dung beetle. See, well, I'm not sure if the level of the dung beetle matters. Actually, I haven't done a lot of research into these beetles. So what we're going to do right now is I'm going to take this guy out of the cave. If I can find my way back out. This way. And we're going to tame it up. Have a look at its stats. Why is there a Fiomia in here? It's quite odd. Hey there, Fiomia guy. What are you doing in this cave? Wandered himself in here. Alright, so we'll be back in just a moment. Alright, so night has fallen on the Ark, as you can see. And we are back at the base. And sure, what's up, Massacre? Let's go over there. So, I've put a dung beetle inside my taming bin. Got the first one in here. There's some poop out here, too. Well, I'll take your poop, too. I'm going to take some poop. I'm going to put it in my zero slot. Zero slot poopy. And we're going to have a look. We're going to go in behind the... Oh, it is! Stop! Man, I always forget to take my dinos off follow, or my Argentavis, anyway. I'm going to walk up into this place. And, Oh, I made it mad! Let me out! Can it come outdoors? It cannot come out the door. Perfect! So if we can get behind this thing and feed it. It's mad. It hit me. No, 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 no. Jerk. Jerk Gentavis. Stay there and be good. That dung beetle wants to break my enclosure. Hey, what's up, dung beetle guy? Is it hurting itself? I just saw blood under its butt. So there's a couple ways to go about this. Apparently you can have them like follow you and attack you inside of the cave. And once they get tired, they'll kind of run away and you can feed them in the butt. But this guy, man, this guy's a pain in the butt. He's mad. Let's get away from here and see if we can reset his anger. Do not need angry dung beetles in our lives. Nobody does. That's a life lesson, kids. Avoid the angry dung beetle, which could be interpreted as like a person that is not good for you. You see, it's still whacking at the walls here. Get it out. Get it out of there. Have a look at this other method. Take the Argentavis, go over here. Where are you? Why are you still attacking the wall? There, now it's a matter of me. So I'm gonna like have it follow me here a little bit. What is that? I just saw something weird in the vertex of the ground. Running around the house. So supposedly, after a while, they'll get tired and kind of run away. Not seeing it yet, though. Come on! There. Now I should be able to feed it, is what I'm hearing? I guess not. I don't know what the deal is. Poop! Alright, so we've got our first dung beetle back over in the general area of our house, and I'm going to try to just tame it out in the open. I think that'll probably be the best bet. So, all we got to do is passive tame. I'm going to get behind it and just fade it. Come here, dung beetle guy. I'm pressing E and I can't fade it. Why can I not feed you, dung beetle? I can't. Did I not have... Oh, I've got poop in there. Why can't I feed you? Punched it in the butt. Now I really can't do anything to it. Very odd. Seems like there's some sort of glitchy thing going on with this dung beetle. Where'd you go? Where is it going? Not sure. You know what? I'm gonna pick it up. Oh, where'd you go? Where'd it go? Not sure what it's doing. Just kind of walking around here. Can I feed you now? No, I can't feed you now. Come on, dung beetle. Feed. No, I almost fed it. I almost fed it. Are you mad at me? Are you? What are you doing? I'm irritated with this dung beetle. Stupid dung beetle. I'm going to go get another one. Alright, so we went into the cave and we grabbed up another dung beetle. And we're gonna try the same kind of deal, but I'm just gonna bring it somewhere. I don't know. Is there like flat, non-swampy area right here? No, there's snakes. Snakes are bad, okay. What about over here? Try right here. I think right here is good. Got the dung beetle, and the dung beetle's just sitting there. And I'm going to try to sneak up behind it and stuff poop in its butt. Okay, so it's a level 12 dung beetle. We stuff poop, now it's mad. So we stuck around for too long. And I'm not really sure. There's like a method to taming these where once they start running away, you can stuff, I guess. I don't really know. Come here, dung. This one's really cool. Their colors are neat. Oh, I let it hit me. All right, so now it's tired. And apparently this is when you're supposed to be able to feed it. Gotta wait till it's hungry. All right, so it's tired. It's just sitting there. So apparently you can do this inside the cave. Do this anywhere. Gotta wait till it's hungry again. But it's like not moving now. You see it kind of stopped? Be hungry for poop, please. So I'm not sure if these guys are just like really glitchy already or... Oh, now it's mad. What's up, mad dung beetle? You gonna chase me around again? Till you get tired and slow? Because you're dungy? Massacre is fine. Come on, dung beetle, get tired and slow again. Cannot catch me. I am too fast at backpedaling. Aren't you gonna get tired again? Come on! Alright, so now it's tired again, right? And so now... Now we can feed it! Oh, ah, no! It got mad again. So this is a method that you can employ. That seems to work just quite fine. I wouldn't bring it into a taming bin because then it'll start attacking the walls and it seems to make it kind of a pain in the butt. So this is the method that seems to work. Just gotta wait till it gets tired. Just kind of backpedal around. Wait for it to get all dungy. There, now it's all dungy, see? It's all slow and dungy. Put some more poop down in here. And we're gonna go up to it and see if we can feed it again yet. Oh, I could have. I was trying. I pressed the button. It didn't work. So let's do the same thing. We're gonna keep backpedaling. We're gonna keep trying to make it tired. We're gonna see if we can feed it again, because I was having a problem that second attempt at feeding it there. Whoop! Come on, man. Start doing that slow, tired thing. No? Not yet? Okay, now it's slow and tired. Oh! But I got close to it and I got angry. What is this magic? No. Going this way. Cannot touch me. Will not allow it. Okay, this way again. Walking over here. Now get slow and dungy. Like a beetle of dung. Alright, so I fed it again. So that's how you do it, guys. You just keep running in circles once they get mad. Then they'll get slow and stupid. And then you can just shove the poop right in them. Come on, one more poop. Shoving. Alright, so we've tamed ourselves a dung beetle. Got it. Its name is, I don't know, Poop Face. We've got this dung beetle named Poop Face. Check out his stats. 320 health, 110 stamina, 167% melee damage, 100% movement speed, and 5.4 weight. So, I don't know what... The weight is really low. But it's supposed to make you up them fertilizers and oils very easily. So, we're going to get another one of these. So, we can have a couple of them doing their work. And then we're going to test them out and see how well they work. Alright, we're back in the cave and we've killed pesky onyxes. They's dead. Here's another dung beetle. Level 76, amazing. So we're gonna take it out. We're gonna bring it back to the base, and I, with the last one, it was low level. I just used whatever feces I could find, but apparently the larger the feces is, the better it is for the dung beetles is. We found our way out of the cave again. No problem at all. We're gonna be on our way over to the base. We're gonna make some of our dinos poop. The bigger ones, and we will feed all of this stuff to this dung beetle. So I'm back at the base. What I'm doing with my big dinos right now is I'm just kind of running around in circles, making them chomp and lowering their stamina quite a bit. Then as soon as it's all the way down, I just take a break, press Z as many times as I can while their stamina fills up, hopefully get a couple of poops out of each time. I just got two poops out of Gemini. Now I want to see how many poops I can get out of Paradigm. Generally, my Rex loses stamina quicker. So now I'm just sitting here waiting for that to go back up. And as... Let's go. Stamina fill. You want a poop. I can feel it. There you go. One poop. Two poops. Two poops. See, you got two poops out of that. Bam. Bam. So I've got... Some, let me see, large, medium. I'm just going to drop that for now. Drop the small, large. So we've got quite a few poops. I want to get a couple of more poops out of this. I want to make sure that I have enough. This level 76 dung beetle, I assume, is going to take more poop to tame out than anything else. Or rather, I shouldn't say than anything else, but then the very low level dung beetle that we had just done. So, this is just a way that I'm using to get, you know, large animal feces faster. And it seems to do a decent job at it. You can get, so far, like every time, I get two poops from a totally empty stamina bar. Come on. Oh, now I'm slow. Now I'm going to try to poop. Come on, stamina. Go back up so I can make Paradigm poop on the ground a couple times. Oh. Oh, nice. Good job. Another poop? All right, this time we only got the one poop out of it. Where's Massacre? So I'm gonna try with the what we got. I don't know, 9 poops or something. Yeah, 9 poops. I'm gonna try with the 9 poops to tame up this other dung beetle. Now let's go grab it out of the taming bin. So the taming bin doesn't seem like it's a good place. If they get aggro, they start attacking the walls. And it's a lot easier to just do it outside. So we're gonna bring this dung beetle outside of the taming bin right here. Leave Massacre over in this general area. Put a poop in the zero slot. Boom. So the Pteranodon. What's up, Pteranodon guy? 92. The dung beetle's after the Pteranodon guy. Oh, now you're after me? All right. So I'm going to do the same thing I was doing with the other one. We're just going to kind of run around in circles, wait for it to get tired, and then feed it up. I'm going to let you see the first feed here. We'll see how much a large animal feces actually does for this level 76 wild dung beetle. And then I'll just finish up the tame off cam. Then we'll figure out what kind of time investment we're looking at to get the fertilizer out of the butt of this dung beetle. Nighttime. I need to game up, but I can't. All right, now it's slow. Get out of the way, Pteranodon guy. So it's slow now. All right, so it's probably going to take 4 of those. And I'm just going to continue this method. Moving around. Tiring it out. Shoving poop in its butt. That's the wrong direction for poop. All right, so when you're doing this method, if the dung beetle finds a trike that it's not happy with, it's just going to try to attack it. Got to be careful with the dinos that are around you. I'm going to take this one. Where am I going to take you? That trike is still mad at this dung beetle. The dung beetle is probably mad at the trike still. I'm going to take a little jaunt away. Let me see. No, it probably wouldn't have been a bad idea to tame it in like the big enclosure or something like that. More trikes over there. There's pretty much nothing right here. Let's see if this works. The last time we took a dung beetle away from something it was mad at, it just like glitched out and forever. Oh, I need taming food in the slot. Thank you. Boom. Oh, it started over. Reset the tame. That's a pain in the butt. You gotta make sure that you don't have that occur. Now, as you can see, it's not mad at me. I'm just sitting here, and this is what I was doing over there until the trike came over and made it angry. And hopefully, I can just sit here now. This dung beetle won't move, and we can just go ahead and finish out its tame. Alright, so we've gone to the last feeding right here. There. Nice. So we're gonna name this one Turd. What's up, Turd? What's your weight stat? Your weight stat 7? I mean, that's amazing. The rest of the stats are health, 1040. Stamina, 320. Melee damage, 209. Movement speed, 100%. So let's go bring... Oh, I do not want you to follow me, Turd. Go bring Turd over here. We're going to see what it takes to make some fertilizer for our... our one little teeny garden that doesn't really need any fertilizer, right? We got Poop Face and Turd in here. What's up, Poop Face and Turd? And apparently they eat poop. That's their thing. Wait. I can only put one poop on them. Wait, up. Poop. Maybe each got a poop on them. And we're going to see just what occurs when we're back. All right, so I took some time to look at the dung beetles, and it seems what you can do is you can put one poop of each type on them. If you put feces that are of the same type, the same size, it'll cue them and do one after the other. But if you put a small, a medium, and a large, it'll do them all in 15 minutes. But I've had this small animal feces on there for a long time, and it's not changing. Now, I put it on afterward, so I'm not sure if that has something to do with it or what the deal is. But so I'm going to take all this stuff off, get it all off of there. I'm even taking that small animal feces off, and I'm going to kind of look at it. But what you're supposed to be able to do is with the large animal feces, you get 3 fertilizer and 6 oil. With the medium, you get 2 fertilizer and 4 oil. And with the small, you get 1 fertilizer and 2 oil. Therefore, you can get 6 fertilizer and 12 oil after 15 minutes using each. So what you're going to see me do is I'm going to have like a large pen full of these when we get the greenhouse all set up, which is going to probably be at the top of the tower build that we're going to do. So I'm going to go ahead and put large, medium, small. We've got one of each on there now, and you be large, medium, small, large, medium, small. So they should be all set up, and they should do, like I said, the 6 fertilizer and 12 oil after 15 minutes now. But you got to make sure also that you have them on wander. I haven't looked into the dung beetles at all until today, so this is my first experience with them as well. So, but they look pretty ballerific. They do a great job. I mean, you're talking about, I just got, you know, 10 fertilizer in a very short amount of time. It was no big deal at all. It was very simple, very easy to accomplish. And that's, it basically negates the need for the compost bin entirely. I just have no need for them as long as you have enough dung beetles. The compost bin isn't on a dino, so if you have, you know, if you're on PvP and someone comes in and kills all your dung beetles, then, you know, you can still get your fertilizer by making up one of these. But I'm going to fill this whole thing up now because I can. Oh, you're already filled. So I'm going to have to get... You know what? I think I have. Don't I have? Yeah, I do. Right here. Give me one of those. Thank you so much. So now I've got large storage bin. We're going to bring it over and put it next to... Come here. We're going to put it next to the trough over here. And that way we can just kind of collect the fertilizer as we work. And I'm going to put it this way so that it's not intrusive. It doesn't stick out or protrude into the pen here. All right, so we've got them all on there, and we're just going to continue to let these guys do their work every day. I mean, I don't really need any fertilizer right now, but when we get there and we're ready, we're going to have all kinds ready for our greenhouse. And again, we're working on gathering the materials, and we're going to work hard every day and get enough seedlings to do this build. I'm going to have to make a little bit more pillars. And we definitely need some walls. But yeah, I'm super psyched to get this started and get it going. I have put it off for too long. We need to get a build video in here. Looks like I need to replace some wood. Oh no, that's not wood. It just got a nice shadow on it. All right. Swimming. Oh man, I really wish that I could hop up on from here. All right. Nope. It's not gonna happen. But yeah, so that's gonna be it for today's episode, folks. We got some dung beetles out of there. They're easy to tame. It's no problem at all. So pretty soon, when we have all of our base built, I guess maybe not pretty soon, but hopefully pretty soon, we'll be able to have a nice pen for those and make a lot of fertilizer and oil. So if you liked today's episode, please press the like button. If you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe. If you have anything to say, do it in the comments below. And as always, be excellent to each other. Have a great day. See you later.